We're like literally like 45 minutes late to doing this podcast today because Daryl wants to do a whole bunch of extra contraptions and stuff today. Can you turn on the left? Do too much. Do too much. Who's here? Nobody's here.
Wait till they get on.
What up, Big Mike? All right, we about to rock.
Let's go. Mike, what up, baby?
All right, y'all. Good evening. Happy Thursday. Sorry, I was rocking.
It's a party house, ain't it?
I was trying to, but you was killing my vibe doing the most. The most stuff.
Yeah.
Anyways, yeah. What's up, guys? It is Thursday. I can't say Wednesday no more because Daryl switched our days to Thursday,
right.
And we're still not set. We were supposed to start at 7 o'clock, and we got another podcast we got to do at 8:30.
Yeah.
So follow us and see us on the Fresh Delivery Show later on at 8:30 tonight, where we are going to be special guests on that podcast. So we have to rush through our podcast today.
Hey, but look though, we finally again to the point where I know for me, like, it gotta be crispy. If it ain't crispy, we just don't get the effect that we need.
Just out of curiosity, didn't you have a week to make this crispy?
Yeah, but you know, we got a ton of things going on, but hey, that's neither here nor there. It's getting there. Y'all see the quality, you know what I mean? You know, now we gotta figure out how we get Facebook, Instagram, all that stuff. But y'all will see the replay, and when you see the replay, you see exactly what we're talking about. You know what I mean?
The background is the fact that he waits last minute and decided to pull all this together at 5 o'clock. Hence why we are now on air. What time is it? 7:54. 54. 44.
Hey, look. So look, went to the gun range earlier with my man Lynn to look at some stuff. That's a good segue into, like, a current event. You know, went up there, you know, we didn't get a chance to shoot because the line was so long. It was, like, a two-hour wait, something like that. But I did play around with some things, looked and shopped a little bit. You know, main thing, man, we got to protect our household. That's how I'm looking at it. You know what I mean? With everything going on crazy around the world, just want to make sure we straight. Somebody run up in here on the tiles, you know.
I'm yawning because this conversation is getting on my nerves between him and, yes, Lynn, if you're watching, if you're signing in, between the two of y'all, it's getting on my nerves, okay? My point is, at the end of the day, I get that. Protect your family,
what
but first, God protects our household. Second of all, when you put things into realistic expectations, so like I said, we have a three-level townhouse right now, okay? I'm on the top level. He's on the bottom level. Mm-hmm. The gun is probably gonna be locked up on the top level. Intruder comes through the main floor.
Right.
Y'all tell me, how much time does he have to go from the bottom to the top to retrieve the gun, to come back down to the main floor, and to shoot somebody?
Yeah, the man, look, we get in a scuffle, they just not coming up there and running and doing anything. We're gonna scuffle and I'm gonna get to that spot. Just like basketball, you get to your favorite spot, you gonna knock it down. You see what I'm saying? But you gotta might fight around some picks, a double screen here and there.
But you're not fighting for your life and you're not retrieving nothing because if you go for the shot, do you not already have your weapon in hand?
No, I don't.
Yes, you do. You got the ball. Yes, you got. If you're going to, the basket, you already had the ball. You already had the ball in your hand. Exactly. You already got the ball in your hand. You ain't got
to
go. Oh, bet. So here we go. So let's perfect. So if you got to retrieve the ball, if you waiting on the ball, in the meantime, what's happening with the rest of the defenders? They could be denying you.
Yeah.
They could be cutting off the pass, or they could get your mans, and they could steal the ball and be going to the other side.
Are you gonna find a way to get to
that's
your spot?
That's what I
thought. Yes or no?
That's not the point.
Are you gonna find a way to get to your spot?
The
yes
point.
Or no?
Hold on.
It's
so
a
let's,
yes or no
let's
answer.
Make a conclusion.
Are you gonna find a way? Yes,
yes
or no?
Okay. Yes.
Thank you.
Wait.
Hey,
but what's the point? The point of the matter is what? To do what?
It's to protect the house.
No, the point of the matter is to score. Since you want to use a basketball analogy, correct?
Right.
You ain't running around with a bunch of like a chicken with your head cut off the whole time.
No, nope, because I know how to get to my spot.
So, because you gotta go. Do you have to score? Right.
Yes.
The purpose of having a gun is not to protect the family. When it comes down to it, you have to do what?
Defend the family.
Execute. Right. Period.
Absolutely.
Right. So with that being said, if you are cutting and denying and you waiting for your weapon and you don't ever get it, did you succeed? No.
Telly said, I got one too, fam. One on the floor, third. Yeah.
Telly, we ain't talk. Listen, we don't care.
Thank you.
But listen, hold on.
Hey, Sarita, thank you. I appreciate it.
She don't know who she's saying facts to. Exactly. Second of all, Telly is a military vet.
He is not somebody
straight off the street, off the hood, who is a now reformed suburbs young man who is trying to pull his life together, okay?
No.
He is a 20 years in vet. So he has utilized his weapon time and time and time and time and time again, okay? Now, at the end of the day, thank you. Zena is on my side.
You on my side of her side.
Thank you.
Hey, listen.
Yes, and while we are sitting here again, meet us on Fresh Delivery Show today at 8:30. If Lynn is on, hashtag your thing.
Lynn and Booba, man, we can't wait, man, to get on y'all show, man. Long overdue.
And Lynn, don't say nothing about no gun stuff, because I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to fuss all y'all out on this darn air, okay? I'm over it. Enough with the guns.
But look, on another note, and right now we're on the current events and things been going on around the house and stuff like that. My nephew Keith started, and thank you, Telly, for hopping on the challenge, a vulnerability challenge.
Yeah.
And that is literally for men who we don't want to express ourselves like that. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, women, you guys always express yourself.
Not all women.
Well, you share your emotions a lot. Way more than men. So this challenge was literally for guys are talking about broken families, you know, breaking the cycle and all that good stuff, and talking about it, whether you're doing it on video, whether you're sharing in your caption. So shout out to Keith for Never Crushing the Greatness for that challenge, and it's still going, and I'm gonna tag a couple of my guys in it. So that was super dope.
Yeah,
I mean?
And while y'all are at it, hashtag he's single ladies. He does everything around our house. Real talk, like handyman and everything. So you got a nice little package. All we got to do is just open him up to express himself more, as he's starting to do.
Right.
Very proud of him for that.
Absolutely.
Holla at me. I'm doing the vetting process, so don't think y'all can go directly to him. I got to vet through it some of y'all, okay? Right. And let you know. I got some single ladies, too, for y'all fellas who are looking.
Holla at nephew. He'll win them.
Right. And for the record, look at Zena said. Zena says she's on my side. Thank you, Zena. Appreciate you.
You know where Zena lives. See, I thought we was cool. You see these? You see that? Come on, man. You're supposed to be on my side. Behold. It's all good, though. I respect you. You know what I mean?
Anyways, so we're moving forward.
Yep.
Anything else we want to talk about, current event-wise? Oh, schools. So since today's topic, we're talking about raising a phenom, okay? The topic was Daryl's topic. I don't know why we're talking about that today.
Because it's good for the simple fact of a lot of people feel like just because...
But it was sparked from something, though.
No, we always been talking about it. We just never talked about it on social media or out in public. It'd always be like through our friends and say, hey, man, CT going to... CT's a phenom. He's way above our time, ahead of his time, you know what I mean? But we can't see it because that's our son. So we want to get feedback on and also express how we feel about it. We never expressed about how we feel about that, you know
that's
what I mean?
True.
We talk about it internally, but for people, they may assume that we already think he's going to the league, or he's nice, or he, you know, don't got to take out the trash.
That's true.
What I mean? And stuff like that.
Well, before we get into it, since we're talking about kids, my question is, how are we sending these kids back to school? This conversation has been going on for the past week. Everybody keeps asking. The topic of conversation for us in Fairfax, they say, we have a two-day option and we have a virtual option. However, for Fairfax County, once you make your decision, which tomorrow is the deadline, ain't it? I think. So, yeah. Tomorrow's the deadline. Once you make your decision, you can't change it. That's it. They locked in for a year. I appreciate Prince William County because I think they choose and they get a month and a half and they could possibly reevaluate where they're at. So if you decided, right. I think everybody's going virtual, Prince William County. And then in end of October, they reevaluated the situation. So what do you think?
It's crazy. We was on board with sending Christian to school for a couple of days because he needs to get the heck up out of the towel crib for a couple of days, right? And he needs to socialize with his friends. But at the end of the day, if they don't know what they're talking about. It's almost like the president, man. He gets on stage and the people in government, they get on stage and they lie. You can tell a real one really knows that they don't know what the heck they're talking about. Or they don't have a complete concrete plan in place, right? So if you know that, we're not sending our son back to school. We'll send him in. We'll do the curriculum, make sure that he does it at home.
Yeah, he's going to get his work done right? Regardless.
And then we'll teach him what they're not teaching him in schools and stuff like that. But he's going to be doing something. But to go back with a not concrete, solid plan, that don't sit well with us.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Not at all. Yeah. So, yeah. So I think we're going virtual. Well, I know. We're going virtual. Absolutely. And that's that.
Yep.
And we'll see what happens from there. But if we end up having to sell a 9-year-old, just know it would be blasted. So we've taken the highest bidder. No, I'm just kidding. Anyways, all right.
Raising the phenom with a question mark. Are we and the other parents and coaches out there who coach and train their kids, are you raising the phenom? Is CT a phenom and how do we feel about it? If you got any questions.
Comments.
Let us know because a lot of you guys is on right now, kind of see what we're talking about and have your own opinions, you know. Ask a question and leave a comment. You want to start it off or you want me to start it off?
You can start off. Knock yourself out. Curious.
So I see it. At 9 years old, I started hooping around this time, but really hooping around 10. And literally he's been doing it since 3 to 4, coming out of the womb, he was really shooting, right? So is he ahead of his time and have a lot of potential? Absolutely, absolutely. Like if he keep doing what he's doing now, working and grades stand straight and he stand, you know, positive and keeping God first, absolutely, I think he can make it, right? But is he a phenom? And also too, are we just let him do what he want to do? No. Like, he got a lot of work to do, right? We're not going to, you know, he have his times when he don't feel like doing anything. And
Every day.
Being lazy. He has a natural ability because his parents played at a high level and stuff like that. But let's get into the mindset of people think, how can I put it?
Well, here's my question is, I would love to be in a room with, like, Kobe Bryant's parents, Dale Curry, LeBron's mama.
LeVar Ball?
No. who else's mama? KD's mama, so she's right around the way. All of them. Like, I would love to see, Grant Hill's people's. I would love to sit down and see how they, especially somebody like Dale Curry, since he already played the game. I don't know everybody else's history like we know his, but since he's already played the game at the elite level, what was his household like raising two young sons? I mean, his daughter too, she's an athlete. She's not a basketball player, but she's an athlete. But what was it like raising them? And did he emphasize, like, if Steph wanted to play, was he on his head like 24/7, or did that come at a later point in life? That's my question, because
I get my own. I mean, if you play basketball, I don't care if you just play basketball, football, or if you just an entrepreneur, you know, and you made it, you know, it got to be a certain type of discipline that comes with being great, any sport, any business, or whatever. So they had to be on the head.
Yes and no,
at some point.
That's the question. At some point. So I think the disconnect for us, so like you said, you started at 9, I started at 9. Both of us took off when we started. It was just a natural ability and we were able to just.
But our skill level wasn't, I know mine wasn't.
No,
I wasn't
hands down.
High school 3 points.
Hands down. Not at all. At by no old. Means, by, no. Right. But we were still kids. So we loved the game. We were outside. We was playing all the time. I think that might be the one difference that is between him is because for us, like, I was with my brother all the time outside literally every day. And if I wasn't outside out with him, my dad had me out in the court doing something.
Right.
I think that's the first thing is he's just not outside. Like, because there's, for one, we never lived in a neighborhood like that. And now we live in a neighborhood and nobody really out here is doing anything like that.
That's true.
So I feel like that might be a difference.
Right.
But then outside of that, for me, it's like, I don't know, my mind just about being childhood. Like, I want him to enjoy a childhood. However, what irritates me is his mouth. Like, you got the, you talk like you are a hooper. Straight up, that you was gonna bust anybody's tail if MJ were
but
walking.
But I mean, you can't get mad at that.
I can't.
Whether he's emulating his older brothers or us or whatever, I'd rather him have a confidence versus not having a confidence. You can tame the confidence, but you can't kind of build it until somebody has happened.
100%. But now you gotta get yourself together. You can't come up in here and talk a whole bunch of junk,
right,
and then don't be outside working.
Yeah.
Like, it don't have one. Number two, my biggest thing at this point in our household is his little stinking attitude. So if he loses at anything, that thing is ready to cry. But be the first trash talking somebody on anything, and when you talking about somebody being that right there is my irritation level where I'm
right. Yeah, absolutely. You know what I mean? I think we do a good job of taming it. You know what I'm saying? But he gonna be all right. He gonna be all right.
Hey, on top of that, I don't want to get to a point. So training a lot of these kids and seeing kids who started his age all the way to high school, you see sometimes where that burnout phase comes from. So you'll have sometimes them kids who is like we're saying, you got hoop, and they're hooping. And by the time they get to their junior, senior year, the love is gone. And that's what I don't want to happen.
A lot of times I know sometimes for me personally, I don't say anything to them just to see how he would react to certain situations. A lot of times, and we talk about this, you know, to some of our friends, often we'll be sitting on the couch and we think he's on the tablet. We think he on, you know, video games or whatever, Fortnite and all that stuff. But he's on watching Kobe Bryant.
Right.
He's watching, like, Steph Curry. He's watching the old Michael Jordan. I'm talking about, like, Dennis Johnson back in 78 and 80.
Right.
I don't know no young kids really doing it. So it has to be something in them. And also, too, he's always around it.
Right.
Ever since he was born, we was always at the gym. Like, he'd be in his baby seat.
So with that being said, that kind of brings up to the point where somebody said, do you think that that's the only reason why he plays is because
somebody just said it the other day.
Yeah,
too,
I forget who he was talking to.
Yeah.
But do you think he's only playing it because he's just been around it all the time?
Right. What's up, Jewel? Yep. I think it's in him. Now, so if we went to the gym every day, he's seeing us working out and all stuff every day, he would just do it. He wouldn't do the extras. Like, he will only do it when we at the gym.
But that goes back to what makes you the phenom, though. Like, I'm not going to lie to y'all. I hate I hate when people get, but I do hate when people gas him up and come up to us and be like, yo, your son about to be, and I'd be like,
But you the parent though, you can't see what other people. That's the thing. Like, it's almost like everybody be like, yo, CT getting tall or he getting tall.
No.
He'll be like, nah, I ain't getting tall, and I'll be like, we see him every day.
I get that, but sometimes I like realists. So like there's people who will come, like I have people in my corner who even if I ain't seen them in a while, and I'd be like, yo, am I losing weight? No. Okay, let me go back to the gym.
I know who that is. I done heard that voice.
Let me go back to the gym. But I can appreciate that. So when it comes to him, as much as I want him to make it, I would love to be that mama. I'm going to be at every single game with my my towel, jersey on, everything. But I don't want everybody to keep gassing him, because then they gas him too. Right. So they come and size us up. Oh yeah, you got this right, kid. Right, right. And then they go to him, oh, you gonna be a dog. Listen, yes, but I want somebody else to say, you can be a dog, but you gotta put that extra work in. I like those comps. I like those people.
Even if he is doing good, I think this is where I'm at now too. Even if he is doing good, I'm saying, nah, that joint was whack, man.
Because sometimes you gotta.
He has a different personality. He don't believe in me. You don't have no confidence in me.
He does that with his daddy. He don't do that with me. He does that with him, because them two be battling that. I think it's just the firstborn thing. I don't know.
Gotta be something.
But I think we gas him up. I think we definitely love him.
Give him his props when he's doing. 100%. 100%. What he's supposed to be doing, then you digging his tail.
So back to the point at hand, how do you know if you're raising a phenom? I mean, so let me premise this with this. I know for a fact, regardless of what you think you know, God ultimately has the plan. Absolutely. So regardless of what your thoughts are and what you think that you're going to do,
right,
it's whatever God's purpose is for his life. However, while we're sitting here on earth living in the flesh, what makes a kid have the potential to be a phenom? Like, I would love to get people like these NBA.
Right, we're telling
you. Elite NBA people on the line to see what did you do in your household that made your kid that potential phenom? Because that's a kid.
Joe Jackson, man, he got them boys where they supposed
Listen,
to be.
Listen, but we can't, nope.
LaVar Ball got them boys where they supposed to be.
Nope. Because you got, where Jello at?
It don't matter. Like, we're two out of three ain't bad. Supposed to be the number one pick. And then one is in the lead. He just, So it's obviously something pushing your kids to a certain level.
And back to the Jacksons.
Was everybody respecting?
Michael Jackson was good. But, he was great.
Thank you.
But he had a whole lot of personal issues that came along with it.
As many kid stars.
Mm-mm.
Like, you a kid star.
But that's what I don't want to have happen to my son. So we ain't Joe Jackson and nothing.
Yeah, absolutely. But it's a certain discipline. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
The work you got to put in. That's what I'm saying.
Hands down.
And having a great balance of it. A lot of people talk down on LaVar Ball. And, he kind of phased out. He is a little quirky, a little bit over the top. You know what I mean?
He's extra.
Straight hood.
He's extra for unnecessary reasons.
But he has a goal in mind. He has a
extra.
Vision in mind.
He's extra. I don't care what you say.
Yeah.
He's extra, and his shoes were ugly.
Tell you what you say, man. I see his focus. He has had. Read that.
You ain't got your glasses on. Right. See what I'm saying? Yeah, see what I'm saying? In marriage, you haven't told him. Get your glasses. Get glasses. You need glasses. Come get glasses. Right. Finally go to the doctor. He got glasses. Ask me where his glasses at. Can't see, not lit.
Read the comment. What you saying, Telly?
Telly said, I see his focus. He has that he's had that for a while when it comes to basketball. He has it. He is my dude, but seriously speaking, facts.
Yeah.
Okay, I hear you, Telly.
Yeah.
You and everybody else.
So he's a phenom yet? I'm going to tell you what's going to make him a phenom. Like, so... He started out with BRYC.
Started from the bottom, now we're here.
Hey. Started
from the bottom.
Started out with BRYC, which is a kind of a lower league, rec league, getting him out, throwing him out there. So he played 3 years up. I think he started off with
He started off as a five-year-old playing on the 6-7-year-old team.
Right, right.
And so on. 6-year-old playing on 7-8.
So he did that 2 years. And I'm like, man, shoot, he's not learning anything. Where I'm from, yo, you go out there in the fire and you work everything.
Well, no, I won't say he won't learn anything. I think he learned a good team concept because his team was very much.
They
won championships.
And he's still playing with
three of them. Right. Three of them, yeah, right. To this day.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
I think that, and then two, he built friendships, which I think is really important. Right, so he learned something.
And
for
it
sure.
was culture,
Yes.
It was culture. It was white, black, Asian, everything. So he's seeing the whole dynamics. Which we're very high on. So that following year, we're like, look, we'll take you down to Richmond, take you down to Hampton. You go out there and get your head bust so you can see, right? So that was like throwing him a deer in the headlights. He went out there, hair was on a little bit, but he was nervous. He cried a little bit, laughed a little bit. So I think this year coming up, once we get through this whole phase and we get back on the game and seeing if he can keep up with some of the kids who are Why are they ranking kids?
That's you already know my thoughts on that. I think it's dumb.
Fourth, fifth grade. They talking about they the fourth.
That's dumb. It's dumb to
first
me.
Number one player in the nation.
No, knowing in 2-3 years they all gonna shoot up at different heights and sizes and mentalities, man. I ain't ranking no kids anyways. And I told him that when he was on that 100 watch list, that's great.
Right. And but he is looking at the ranking list.
But personally, almost. I don't care. And he don't care. So I don't want to hear nothing about no ranks.
Right.
Period.
Right.
You rank when that scholarship come through. How you doing? Or that NBA contract come through. Now we ranking. But until then, sit down somewhere. But anyways, I think for him to become... I think to be a phenom, I think he has part of it where the studying aspect. He definitely studies. He knows stats. He knows
everything.
A lot of current events when it comes to the game. I think the missing aspect is his drive to be outside hooping on a regular basis without somebody having to tell him. Which I think part of it...
And we got a goal in the back.
Yes. So. Which I think part of it is... I think it's kind of... Like where he's at, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, like when me and my brother grew up right down the street, like kids stayed outside in the neighborhood, going to courts, going to whatever, coming through the crib. Right. So it was like naturally we're always going to be outside. Him, he's by himself. I mean, we got a couple of neighbors, but nobody's really, they're younger. A lot of them are younger. And
they're hooping, they're not.
Yeah, ain't nobody hooping. Really hooping like that. I mean, he got his boys that he went over to, like his friends last night, but that's a whole nother neighborhood. So it's like you got to drive him and go take him over there all the time. So I think that, so to get to that phenom status, I think he would have to mentally get there on his own, be able to go out there on his own.
No, but he also got to play in tournaments and stuff when he gets to that level and get his head busted.
Oh, yeah. Outside of that, yeah. But once you get there, I think it starts here, though. Once you lock it down here, getting into that environment is going to be a small adjustment, but you're going to be so used to just working that when you get out there, it's not going to be nothing. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. So the bottom line, what we say is, he's really good at his age. We're going to push him. We're going to make sure he's doing what he's supposed to do with the academics, working out. Are we going to be a little bit tough?
Yes.
Yes, we'll be a whole lot tough. But at the end of the day is he got to want it and he got to do the work.
But we're going to be tough. Him. We're going to be tough in the sense of if this is what you want, this is why we're going to be tough.
Right, but we've told
him on several occasions to this very day. We might have just told him a couple of days ago, yo, if you do not want to play this game of basketball, you do not have to play. No. I know don't nobody in the world. I don't know why don't none of y'all believe us when we say this. For real. We don't care if either one of our boys do not play this game.
Right. He'd be hurt just a little bit.
He'd be hurt. I just want them to be good, successful young men and happy.
Yeah.
Period. I don't want them to grow up and go into therapy later in life like, yo, I just felt like I had to play because my family played. No, I don't ever want that ever to come out of their mouths. I want them to genuinely play this game because they love this game. Mm-hmm. I can genuinely say that I believe Christian truly loves this game. So I don't have a worry about that aspect of it. Isaiah, I don't know. Bam Bam, he ain't no telling with this one. This little thing right here.
Wrestling or something.
And football. He already outweighs his brother.
Yeah.
So we don't know what's going to happen with him. But CTY's, we have told him and we will continue to tell him, you play because you want to play. You are not hurting our feelings if you decided you wanted to hang up this game. Because at the end of the day, it ain't like we can't still go outside and play.
Absolutely.
Like, the Lord has blessed us to continue to do what we do with basketball.
I'm pushing 40. I'll be 40 in October.
What's the air up there like?
You be there in 3 years.
4 years. Don't play me.
Don't play me.
He is a hater. Hater.
Anyway. Hey, what y'all think about the new studio, man? The new studio, this new setup, you know, trying to do something, man, and make it real nice for y'all, man, because we got some great stuff coming up, great topics, fun, inspirational, spiritual, all that good stuff.
I can't wait to get people in here. Get people to come through.
Lit.
Keep people to come through so we can have our podcast and everything's working out, but obviously, Corona got us locked up.
Right.
Locked up, won't let you out. Mm-mm.